Suppose you want to purchase a house. Your take-home pay is $3,450 per month, and you wish to stay within the recommended guidelines for mortgage amounts by only spending one-fourth of your take-home pay on a house payment. You have saved $16,900 for a down payment, and you can get an APR, an annual percentage rate, from your bank of 4.7% compounded monthly. What is the total cost of a house you could afford with a 30-year mortgage? All right, the formula for the maximum purchase price is kind of a bugger. It's got a lot of stuff going on. PMT is your monthly payment. Now, this formula is without adding in the down payment. So we'll find this first and add in that down payment at the end. All right, so this PMT is the monthly payment. R is interest rate as a decimal. N is the number of times the bank is compounding per year. And T is time in years. Okay, one thing to notice is that there is a negative in this exponent. And if you're using a calculator that's a TI-30 or an older TI-84, you will definitely want to put parentheses around this exponent. Okay, so summarizing the pieces, we're going to need the payment amount, monthly payment, and it states in the problem that the guideline is you only want to spend one-fourth of your take-home pay on a house payment. So if your monthly take-home pay is $3,450, one-fourth of that, just multiplying, I got $862.50. So that would be your monthly payment. Interest rate is a decimal, is 0.047, and is the number of times the loan is compounded per year, and that's 12, and it's a 30-year mortgage. T is time in years. All right, so putting all of this into the formula, the max price without the down payment, it looks like this. Okay, so there's a lot going on that we'll have to get into the calculator. You're welcome to work a problem like this in pieces, but you want to be careful about rounding in between steps, and you definitely want to work from the inside out. In other words, do the inner parentheses expression first, then raise it to this power, subtract it from 1, take that number, and then divide it by this quotient down here. So in my opinion, I think it's easier to get it into the calculator in one step as long as you are paying attention to using your parentheses. Okay, so putting this into the calculator, it's that monthly payment times, I'm going to open up that outer set of parentheses, 1 minus, opening up the inner set of parentheses, 1 plus 0.047 divided by 12, closing the inner set of parentheses, using the caret key to move my cursor in the exponent. Now, you want to use parentheses here if you have an older calculator. I don't need to for my calculator, but I'm going to anyway. Okay, so I have a negative 12 times 30. I want to use my sine key, not my subtraction key. That'll be negative 12 times 30. And then I want to close the parentheses and right arrow out of the exponent. I want to close the outer set of parentheses for that numerator. And then divide by, and here it's important to open up another set of parentheses so you are clear as to what the denominator expression is for this problem. Okay, so I have 0.047 divided by 12, close the parentheses there, and then enter. Okay, so that answer is 166,300 and $1.03, but this is not including the down payment. So here I can add in that down payment of $16,900. So the actual max purchase price would be $183,201.03.